Hello students, how are you? I hope you all are fit and fine. So dear students, as you know that we are practicing revision test 3 and chapters we have practiced, extra questions we have discussed. Now we are discussing writing a letter for placing an order, okay? So in my last video I gave you a question in homework. So now I'm going to write the answer of that question. You can match your answer. Content may vary, but way of presentation should be same, format should be same. Okay, your content may vary, doesn't matter. Okay, the question which was given in homework: you are the proprietor of a cosmetics shop. You want to place an order for various products. Write a letter to the wholesale dealer placing order for various products in 120 words. You are Sandeep Sneha. Okay, so first of all, dear students, you know very well you will be writing your address as given in the question.
B67 shopping complex where Panipat after that date 18th, after leaving a blank line, 18th January 2021.
Then the manager
whom you are writing the letter
Shilpa Cosmetics, it is Shilpa Cosmetics Private Limited.
Shilpa Cosmetics Private Limited.
Where it is? Ambala. Okay, after that, subject.
What is the subject? Placing an order for various cosmetics. Okay. Then salutations, sir.
Okay, dear students. First, sender's address as given in the question. Complex it is. Sorry, it should be complex. Then date. Then the person whom you are writing the letter, address of the person whom you are writing the letter, subject, salutation, sir. Okay, so now let me rub it and write down the content. You can start this way. I got your mail yesterday. Yesterday, regarding the rates of your products, regarding the rates of your products. I request you to send me the following products. Send me the following products at the earliest. Okay. Now mention the products which you want to order. First, you should write serial number, then product. And after that, manufacturer, manufacturer it is. After that, quantity. Okay. So first, serial number 1, you want cold cream. Of which manufacturers? Nivea. Quantity 10. Then you want deodorant, Nivea 10. At least 4 items you should answer, but I recommend you to at least 5 items you should write. You should order. 3 powder set 10. It should be in a proper table as I have written here on the board. Z quantity 10. Hair oil. Okay, then shampoo.
So here you haven't written it is of 50 gram or 100 gram because already through email you had a discussion regarding it. So that is why it is okay. There is no issue. Okay. So this way, I got your mail yesterday regarding the rates of your products. I request you to send me the following products at the earliest. These are the products which you have mentioned. Now, write the closing paragraph. Kindly send me the bill through email. Kindly send me the bill through email so that we can send you the payment through email so that we can send you payment. Do not forget to mention your account number. Do not forget to mention your account number. Do not forget to mention your account number. The payment will be transferred to your account. The payment will be transferred. The payment will be transferred to your account through RTGS. Account transfer through RTGS, NEFT, or you can also write online banking. It's just a sample content. You can take some line, phrases and ideas from it. You need not to write exactly what I am writing. It is just a sample example. Okay, dear students. Kindly feel free to talk to the undersigned if you have any doubt. Kindly feel free. Kindly feel free to talk to undersigned if you have any
doubt. Okay, so yours faithfully
or yours sincerely, both are correct here. Yours faithfully, Sandeep.
Okay, so it's all about an ordering letter. Once again, in my last video also an ordering letter was done, and here too. Now dear students, we have finished the syllabus of RT 3.3. Now going to start the revision of next RT, okay, RT 3.4, which actually it was given homework, so that is why I discussed answer. Now let us discuss the chapters of RT 3.4. So the glimpses of India will be there in your RT 3.4. So let us revise. Written by L. Boser Easter. Part 1, A Baker from Goa. Introduction. A Baker from Goa is a pen portrait of a traditional Goan village baker who still has an important place in his society. The narrator is traveling through the memory lane, thinking about the loaves of bread a baker delivered every morning. Summary of this part. God is very much influenced by the Portuguese. Their traditional work can be still seen there. The Portuguese are famous for preparing the loaves of bread. We can come across the bakers of bread. The winter tells about his childhood days in Goa, when the baker used to visit their friend. He used to visit the house twice a day. In the morning, his jingling sound of the bamboo woke them from sleep. They all ran to meet him. The loaves were purchased by the manservant of the house. The villagers were much fond of the sweet bread known as bol. The marriage gifts were meaningless without it. So the baker's furnace in the village was the most essential thing. The lady of the house prepared sandwiches on the occasion of her daughter's engagement. In those days, the bread sellers wore a particular dress known as kabai. It was a single piece long frock up to knees. Even today, they can be seen wearing a half pant that reaches just below the knees. People usually comment that he is dressed like a padder. Baking was a profitable profession in the old days. The baker of his family never starved, and they looked happy and prosperous. Now part 2, Coorg. Coorg is a coffee producing area in Karnataka, state of India. It is situated midway between Mysore and the coastal town of Mangalore. This land is famous for its rainforests and spices. The writer seems to be fascinated by the beauty of the place and says that it must have come from the kingdom of God. It is smallest district of Karnataka. Now summary. Coorg is a heavenly place which lies midway between Mysore and Mangalore. It is the smallest district in Karnataka and has evergreen forest, spices and coffee plantations. The best season is between September and March, when the weather is perfect for a visit to Coorg. The people of Greek or Arabic descent, it is rumored that a part of Alexander's army drifted here and found it impossible to return. They married amongst the locals, so their traditions and rites may be different from other Indians. Some people say that Coorgis are of Arabic descent, as many people wear a long black coat with embroidered waist belt, which is similar to kufia worn by the Arabs. The people of Coorg are known for their hospitality and recount many tales of bravery. General Kariyappa, the first army chief, was a Coorgi. The Kodavus are the only people in India to carry firearms without a license. A variety of wildlife like Mahasheer, a large freshwater fish, kingfishers, squirrels, langurs and elephants can be seen here. Coorg is also well known for high energy adventures like river rafting, canoeing, rappelling, rock climbing, etc. The Brahmagiri Hills give the climber and awe-inspiring views of Coorg. A walk across the rope bridge leads to the 64-acre island of Nisarg Dham. Baila Kupe in Coorg is India's largest settlement of Buddhist monks. These Buddhist monks can be seen here dressed in red ochre and yellow robes. Now third part, the tea from Assam. Introduction. This is a very short description of Assam, a northern eastern state in India. This state is famous for its tea plantations. In this extract, Pranjol, a youngster from Assam, is Rajveer's classmate at a school in Delhi. Pranjal's father is a manager of a tea garden in Upper Assam, and Pranjal has invited Rajveer to visit his home during the summer vacation. Summary of the chapter. Tea from Assam is an interesting story about tea, its history and significance. Two boys, Rajveer and Pranjal, are traveling to Assam. Rajveer tells Pranjal that over 80 crore cups of tea are drunk every day throughout the world. The train passes through green hills with a sea of tea bushes as far as can be seen. Rajveer is very excited, but Pranjal, who has been brought up on a plantation, does not share his excitement. Rajveer then tells him about the various legends, Indian and Chinese, behind tea. He tells him how a Chinese emperor by chance discovered tea back in 2700 BC. Another story was about how 10 tea plants grew out of islets of Bodhidharma, a Buddhist ascetic. These words, chai and chini, are Chinese words. It was only in the 16th century that tea came to Europe. By now, they had reached Marian Junction, where they got down and set off for Dhekiaberi tea estate. On both sides of the road, there were tea bushes with women plucking the tea leaves. Pranjal's father told Rajveer that he would tell them many more things about tea plantation. So, dear students, it's all about this lesson in which we have seen it is having three parts. The first part is a baker from Goa, and second part is Coorg, and third part is tea from Assam. In the first part, the story of a baker from Goa has been given, how still the baker is imported in Goan village, it has been described. In the second part, the beauty of Coorg and the best time for visiting the Coorg has been described. And the third one, the origin of tea, how it was discovered. Okay, so about tea and the legends behind tea, tea's discovery has also been described here. So now in the dear students, so it's all about this video. In my next video, I will discuss questions and answers from this chapter, and one more poem is there in your syllabus of RT 3.4, that is Custard the Dragon. Okay, so it will also be discussed in the next video. Okay, so keep learning, keep practicing, must do written practice. These things are very important, and I always in the class too, I keep giving you instructions, must follow the instructions to score better, so that you can score better in your board examination. So thank you students for watching this video. See you tomorrow.